these, like, look at the brand new ones growing in here. They start out green, these little ones, so that they're brand new beans of the yellow ones.
So today's episode is a little bit different. I'm here with the lovely Prisca, and she is going to tell us all about this aeroponics tower garden. If you live in an apartment or a condo or a townhouse, or maybe you just don't have any place outside to plant, maybe you rent. There's all sorts of different reasons why it might make sense for you to have an indoor grow station like this. So we're going to learn all about it today. If you don't know me, I'm Nadia. I'm from Embracing Harvest. I talk all about eating healthy food with local ingredients and all about growing food on your own. So if that interests you, hit that subscribe button below. But for now, let's talk all about this very cool aeroponics tower garden. So thank you, Prisca, for being on the show today. I'm super excited.
Thank you for having me. I'm excited too.
So what's going on here? What do you have growing?
So this is my tower garden. It's an aeroponic growing system, but we have, so far, we're growing, what's gone really crazy is the tomatoes. I almost pulled one out before shooting this because they actually start at the bottom and this one's going all the way up to here.
These are huge.
They're huge. So I am just this morning noticed my first flowers on the tomatoes, and that was super exciting. But we're also growing bib lettuce, arugula, there's dill, rainbow chard, kale, three different types of beans. So here you can see, maybe you can see, the string beans. These are the purple beans. And then I also have some yellow beans growing right there. And
that's amazing. Like these are actual, like, real beans. Like,
they're real beans.
They're full size. The same stuff you see outside is very cool.
I know. I actually was just getting ready to pick these, but I thought I'm gonna leave them for another day here. And I've green ones growing on your side of the tower. But I also have basil, fresh basil, growing here. And what else? Cilantro. And I started growing strawberries back here, but they're not strawberries yet. I haven't had any flowers yet.
That's so exciting. A lot of people, strawberries.
Yeah, like, I know.
Strawberries, right? Yeah.
Exactly. And my son asks every day, like, do we have strawberries yet?
Yeah.
I planted them last, and so that's probably why they're taking a little longer.
Very cool. I love it.
Thanks.
Okay, so my first question to you when we first met was, like, what's the difference between this is called aeroponics,
which is different
from hydroponics?
Yes. Well, actually, it's a type of hydroponics.
Oh, okay.
I actually did some research because I assumed that, so because they're both soilless, and hydroponics means growing without soil and growing with a nutrient and mineral rich water instead. And so, with this one, with aeroponics, the difference between that and aeroponics is, with aeroponics, the leaves the roots are spritzed, like, with water. So so they don't sit in the water, like, the roots don't all sit in the water. They get misted, like, because the water's coming down and only just on the roots. So,
cool.
Yeah, so it's funny, you'll pull the root, if you pull this out, the roots sometimes are really long. And
really?
I looked inside here yesterday, and I actually saw roots growing into the water reservoir. So they're that long.
How long does it take? So after you plant something, I saw that you have some stuff, so we'll show you guys in a second how this looks, but it's
yeah.
Very cool. She's starting some plants.
Brand new seedlings.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So how long from that point until you can actually eat? Because, like, you think about outside in the garden, something can, like, baby lettuce can take, I don't know, a couple weeks, but tomatoes could take 3 months. So, like, is
right.
It the same as outside, or is it a little bit faster? Like, how does that
Well, work? They claim it's 3 times faster than growing outdoors or traditional gardening, only because it's getting exactly the nutrients and minerals it needs all the time. I can control the lighting, I can control what it's getting for nutrients and everything. So, but that being said, I would say I started with the seedlings, and within 2 or 3 weeks, most of them were ready to put in. I would say, I think I saw you at about 2 weeks when they were all, you know, maybe mm-hmm. a lot of them were about that big.
I'll see if I can find a picture of when I, because I met her, a month?
Yeah, it was, about almost a month ago.
Okay, and this looks very different. So I'll see if I can find a picture. I did take some pictures of it at that point, so I'll just so you can compare the two. So yeah, that's.
And I would say within a month of transplanting them in here, it was shockingly huge. The bib lettuce was giant. We were eating off of the tower easily within a month of transplanting in here. So I also, this morning, saw our very first cucumbers. I just was beside myself. I was so excited about this morning.
That's amazing. I love it.
Yeah.
And that's, so it's June, we're in Canada, and I don't have cucumbers on my outdoor tomato, or my outdoor plants yet. So this is very cool that you have it earlier
right.
than you would have had outside if you weren't doing like greenhouse or cold frames and stuff like that. But very cool that you can push the boundaries.
Well, and now I can grow them all year long
right.
indoors.
So this is possible. You can have this running 12 months of the year?
Right.
Okay.
Yes. Uh-huh.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, so how big is this?
So
you can probably see us in the frame.
So are you? So I would say it's 2.5 feet round. But I'm just over 5 feet tall, this much over 5 feet tall. So you can tell this is a pretty good size.
Okay, so we can obviously see how awesome this is. Are there any drawbacks that you've experienced so far? Anything that people would want to know if they were considering something like this?
Oh, I think that some of the things you can't do in the tower garden are you can't do anything with root, that's a root vegetable, obviously.
Right.
Those can't, and I actually personally made that mistake. I it didn't occur to me that radishes needed to grow I had put radishes. I had put radishes in here. And so anyway, that's kind of a no-no.
Root vegetables are a no-no.
Right, right. So carrots, things like that, can't do. The only other thing is lots of these vegetables and herbs and everything and lettuces, they require a decent amount of water. Mm-hmm. And so it is watering for 15 minutes every hour. What I've found is
it turns on automatically every 15 minutes, every hour for 15 minutes.
Right. Yeah. And then I've heard though that I haven't tried lavender yet, and I was about to, and I heard from someone that that's actually too much water
likes,
for lavender.
It does.
And
likes
so
drought,
it,
for
so
sure.
It floods it, and it kind of drowns the lavender. So,
yeah.
Things that require drier climate, I think you can always adjust to this. So let's say you were only growing things that were grown in a drier climate, mm-hmm. or you just have a second tower garden that has that doesn't get water as often.
Okay.
So those would be the things.
Yeah. Okay.
That
so no root vegetables, nothing that likes drier conditions. So that's, and I mean, take advantage of those spaces outside, right? Because if you want to make gardening easier, then you can plant more drought-tolerant plants outside. Obviously, it's what I do, certainly, and my front yard is filled with drought-tolerant plants. But, this is great for anything that loves water, because it does it for you. You don't have to worry
Absolutely.
About ever remembering to water.
And I've never been a successful outdoor farmer. and part of that is because I came from Colorado, from a very dry climate.
Right.
And so even unless I was really vigilant and never went on vacation in the summer, things would just dry up and get crispy, and I just couldn't make things work. So this has been really foolproof, and it's really been nice beginner's garden.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of irrigation for that reason.
Yes, absolutely. Yes.
Yeah, this is awesome. Okay, so if anyone's wondering, what kind of price point are we looking at? Like, just, ballpark, so it was like...
Sure. Well, I was telling you, there was a woman that came up to me at the fair and said, okay, give it to me straight. Is it like $15,000? I'm like, oh my God, no.
Yeah.
So anyway, I actually, in US dollars, this, the main kit has everything you would need, including your seedling starter kit, your pump, your... everything to get started aside from the lights. So everything here but not the lights is $525 US plus shipping and tax. And then in Canadian, I believe it's around $615. Dollars.
That's not bad.
Yeah.
Like, that's a lot of food you're packing in here.
Right.
And the beauty is too, is you know what's in it, right? Like
So there's no bugs.
Yeah.
There's no weeds.
Yeah.
It's really, when you can keep it inside, there's no bugs.
Yeah.
So.
And I mean, it costs money to grow outside.
Right.
When you're pushing the boundaries of the seasons too. Sorry, there's a cat right behind the camera if you're hearing like jingles. Yeah. Is it a girl or a boy?
It is a girl. Her name is Poca.
Okay, yeah. So in case she makes an appearance. you either need like a greenhouse or even cold frames, like anything you're gonna do to push the boundaries of the seasons to grow 12 months of the year, unless you live in a really hot climate, costs money.
Right, so absolutely. Absolutely.
Out of the question.
And grow lights anywhere are costly as well. These run about 250 US.
Okay.
And I believe like around 325 Canadian.
Okay. So great. That's awesome. So that gives you some kind of perspective as to what you're looking at if you're interested in something like this. And if you are, I'm going to link up to a site that you can go to find all the information, like way more than we're obviously going to go through in a
video. And to ask questions and, too.
Yeah, for sure. If you have any questions for Prisca, she'll be in there in the comments and answer whatever questions you have on it, because I am no expert in hydroponics. The only time I've ever tried it, I think one of the first times that I tried growing food, like, I don't know, 10, 15 years ago, was a little tiny hydroponics kind of little setup. Nothing like this. I didn't love it, but it wasn't like this.
Right.
So
I mean,
I got like two little basils, like a tuck.
Yeah.
And I didn't know what I was doing or anything like that. So if I had this, I would have been way more into it. So that's awesome. So thank you so much. But before we go, I am a lover of seeing what everyone does outside. Can we take a look at what you're doing outside as well?
Yes, okay, absolutely.
Cool. So let's go outside.
Okay. All right.
Okay, so show me what you have going on here.
All right, so we rent here, so there's not very much I can do.
Reason why you have the tower garden.
Yes, of course, absolutely. So, so far I've put in some marigolds because I've heard they're really amazing for pests, but I've just planted a jalapeno. So, and I'm getting ready to plant some of this other stuff.
This is looking pretty big already.
Well, that one I didn't grow from scratch. I actually bought that just about a week ago, like when I knew you were coming, you know, and I'm like, well, I definitely want to plant a jalapeno anyway. And
I can see some flowers.
Look at that. Yeah, that was fast.
One, two, three, four flowers for sure.
Oh, that's awesome.
And jalapenos are great too, because it's so much easier than like a big bell pepper. Like they don't have the same pest problems. You don't get some of the same like rotting underneath. Sometimes I find like big peppers
are
way harder than small, like hot peppers.
Yeah.
And even just little bell peppers. So yeah.
And so the sweet peppers will go in the tower garden then.
All right.
So, and then so far I've bought just some strawberries. I don't have flowers on my indoor strawberry plants yet, but these already have leaves. I had flowers. And these, you can tell now they moved them outside. They have bugs have been like found them a little bit, I guess.
That's
But these are
the radishes.
And it's probably hard to see, but they're like, they're the long skinny radishes and they're growing actually out of the soil.
These are huge leaves for a radish.
I know. Well, because they were growing inside for so long. Oh my gosh, it was crazy. So
yeah, the awesome thing too, like radishes, I mean, even with the bugs, you can still eat those leaves.
Yeah.
Like you don't
awesome. Yeah. Good.
Yeah, that's awesome. Good for you.
So, and then on the side, we have some herbs, but we've had a few things that came back already. And then in addition, I've added some chives, but it looks like our cilantro must have reseeded itself because I just see the very little sprouts of cilantro coming up. And then we already have some thyme and I believe some oregano that came back. So
beautiful.
Yeah.
That's awesome. And we talked, so when I met her, she was saying, you were saying that I had talked about lemon balm in one of my videos and
said
you were gonna look, she was gonna look for lemon balm. I'm like, I will bring you a lemon balm.
Yay! I'm so excited about this. Thank you so much for bringing me this.
Yeah, it's awesome. So the only thing to keep in mind with lemon balm is if you let it go to seed, it will be everywhere.
Okay. I will keep an eye on it.
When it goes to seed, just clip it back and it will be fine.
Okay. Maybe I'll just let a tiny bit go to seed so I can get a little bit more.
That's where that one came from.
Oh, awesome. That's fantastic. Well, thank you. I'm really excited about this.
You're welcome. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, this is awesome. I love that you are taking advantage of some of this outdoor space that you have, but also making it work for you with the tower garden. That is awesome.
Yeah.
So thank you so much for being on this episode.
Oh my gosh, it was such a pleasure. I had so much fun.
I had so much fun too. I love it. So thanks for watching. And next week, I think I'm going to do a video on
that rhubarb drink I was talking about in one of my last videos, because I make a like killer rhubarb drink. It's so good. So I think that's what I'm going to do.
Totally want to try that.
For next week's video, thanks. Okay, so I will see you next time, and thanks for watching. Bye.
Thank you.
The biggest one, it looks like.
This one, is this what you're pointing to?
Oh, no.
Oh, this one.
Look at that. How funny. There's a couple right here. I didn't even see that one. But I love all the little curlicues on the vines. They're so cool.